Simon & Schuster Audio presents Soulbbatical, A Corporate Rebel's Guide to Finding Your Best Life by Shelley Paxton. Read by the author.
For my parents, thank you for raising me to be independent, courageous, and curious. I know I've made you regret it on more than one occasion. Introduction. Don't listen to this. A rebel after my own heart. You just couldn't resist, could you? Well, good, because this is where the story really begins. Soulbbatical may be a made-up word, but I promise you, it's a very real experience. It has the power to transform your life just as it did mine. But you can't write a book with a made-up title without explaining why you made it up, right? So here goes. Initially, I mashed together the words soul and sabbatical to describe my desire to stray from a traditional career path and blaze new trails toward understanding myself and my bigger purpose in the world. I wanted a handle that signified the depth and importance of my decision, something that screamed, "This is different." This is not a conventional sabbatical. It's an internal exploration of self and potential. It's about creating new possibilities, so it seemed fitting to create a new word. It's not about leaving your job. It's about finding yourself. It's about what happens when you're ready to liberate your soul from the clutches of your ego. I realized along the way that the essence of Soulbbatical is not a departure from the real world. It's a way of being in the real world. It's a way of creating the life you really want versus settling for what you think you should have. It's about living and leading from a place of authenticity and courage. It's about stepping into your power and leaning into your purpose in order to unleash your wildest potential. It's about becoming chief soul officer of your own life and accepting responsibility for nurturing both yourself and your soul. It's about accumulating self-worth, not suffering for the sake of net worth, and profoundly understanding that these don't have to be mutually exclusive after all. When we slow down long enough to know ourselves, align with our souls, and set intentions for what we really want, magic happens. And massive impact. My dirty little secret, well, one of the many that you'll learn about as this story unfolds, is that I want to become an impact billionaire, to borrow a phrase from my dear friend and brilliant coach, David Taylor Klaus. Impact is the new currency for those of us who want to make a real difference in the world. So I'm declaring here that the mission of Soulbbatical is to liberate a billion souls, to start a movement inside and outside the corporate world that has each and every one of us living and leading more authentically and courageously, that has us rebelling for what we believe in, not who we think we should be or how we think we should look or act. Imagine being part of a soul-centered movement where more of us are creating lives and businesses we love, rooted in meaning and fulfillment. And where we push companies to invest in developing their own souls, to reflect these same values in their cultures and leadership principles. Imagine what could happen if more companies began to cultivate cultures that recognize and celebrate employees as human beings, not human doings, that flip the time-off script from a payoff for hard work to a prerequisite for smart work, that celebrate heart over hustle. Time away is not only crucial to our mental and physical health, but to fostering creativity and innovation as well. It gives us the chance to reflect, discover, play, reinvigorate, be inspired, and find perspective, all of which can reveal ideas, connections, and meaning in a way that our day-to-day cannot. As my coach Rich Litvin loves to say, we have to slow down to speed up. How different would our lives feel if we lived and worked by this mantra? I dream of the day when supporting radical self-care for employees is on the C-suite agenda, and company-sponsored Soulbbaticals are the norm. Now that's fucking impact. And I know we're not starting from scratch, you and I. We're standing on the shoulders of giants who've been modeling and magnifying flavors of this so beautifully for years. Oprah Winfrey, Arianna Huffington, Brené Brown, Marie Forleo, Simon Sinek, and Vishen Lakhiani, just to name a few. The principles of Soulbbatical have helped me discover and live my best life, and to become my most authentic, badass self. I feel vibrant and healthy and powerful and so fucking alive. Everything is accessible. Choice, freedom, joy, love, abundance, prosperity, and success. Owning your purpose and speaking your truth and courageously creating the life you want are like rocket fuel for a kind of holistic success I never even knew was possible. Maybe you didn't either. Maybe that's why this book brought us together. So let's back up for a minute. I've got some splaining to do. You're probably still wondering who walks away from one of the coolest jobs on the planet. Who works her ass off for a quarter of a century to become the global head of marketing for one of the most iconic brands in the world, only to voluntarily flip it the bird? Who leaves a lucrative executive position to become chief soul officer of her own life? Me, apparently. Me and my rebel soul. Despite the fear, uncertainty, and chorus of doubters around me, I felt an obligation to live my life with greater intention. To turn the tables and define my terms of engagement for however many years I had left on this planet. To chase fulfillment until I was breathless. I'm living proof that it's never too late. I left Harley-Davidson at 46, started my own business at 48, and am writing this, my first book, to be published by the time I'm 50. I'm not sure there's any greater gift than living life on your terms. Of course, early on, most people, my family included, still presumed that I was going on an extended holiday and would boomerang back to the corporate world a year later with a sun-kissed glow, an exotic lover, and a renewed hunger for day-long meetings. They also thought I was fucking crazy. In the beginning, I had no real idea of where I was headed or what I might find. I simply sensed that there was something of tremendous value to be discovered if I was willing to take the risk. I would be like Christopher Columbus, only cuter, sailing solo, and navigating the high seas of self, arguably more treacherous than the Atlantic. I was crystal clear on one thing at the time. I felt wildly unfulfilled. Despite the titles, money, and accolades, I couldn't ignore a deep, gnawing sense that I wasn't being true to myself. That I had lost my identity in service of my career. That with every passing day, I was dying a little bit more inside, spiraling into what felt like emotional and spiritual bankruptcy. I wondered whether success and fulfillment could coexist. Was it really possible to feel success full instead of success empty? And I secretly worried about who I was becoming. Keeping up appearances was exhausting and making me sick. Actually, I worried about a lot of things before I made the decision to leave Harley-Davidson. The tracks that played on an infinite bully loop in my head were: my identity is precariously tethered to a successful career. I'm no one without a title. The things I'm supposedly good at don't make me happy. The things that make me happy can't pay the bills. I've been chasing someone else's dream all these years. I will disappoint the ones I love and who love me the most. I'm a fraud who will be exposed for undeserved success. I'll be alone for the rest of my life. Saying any of this out loud will make me seem ungrateful for the abundance of privilege and good fortune I've been gifted. Sound familiar? I'll bet. Stick with me. This story is about learning to put that shit on mute, or at least turning the volume way down. Soulbbatical reminded me that I had a profound responsibility to stand face to face with the raw, unvarnished, fully exposed me and acknowledge her deepest fears and desires. To embrace the discomfort of my own feelings until I stood firmly inside my own identity and story, not someone else's. And to shed the protective armor that I had so carefully curated, layer by agonizing layer. Whatever shape that took, and wherever it pulled me, I committed to staying open, and to carrying a hefty torch into the cave so I could illuminate the experience and draw a roadmap, first for myself and then for you. Soulbbatical was a purposefully and blissfully unstructured concept in the beginning. It started simply as a slowing down to heal and nurture my neglected soul. A healthy dose of luck and synchronicity also took me to some wild new places where I did the deeper inner work of reflection. The laissez-faire of the French countryside, the magical and rugged islands of New Zealand, the zen of coastal California, and the majestic stillness of the Canadian Rockies all served as stunning backdrops for lessons I was destined to learn.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.